In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. O God, who on this day, through your only begotten Son, have conquered death and unlocked for us the path to eternity, grant, we pray, that we who keep the solemnity of the Lord's resurrection may, through the renewal brought by your Spirit, rise up in the light of life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. So the prayer we just prayed was the collect, or the opening prayer for Mass this day, this Easter Sunday. And it really encompasses the theme that Easter brings us, hope. It's a hope that far exceeds your hope for your favorite team to win a game, or to see your favorite band in concert, or to get that big promotion at work. This hope is only given through the resurrection, by Christ, through his passion, death, and resurrection. He merits this hope for us. This hope is our hope for heaven. This is our hope to be a saint. The Catechism says that this is the hope that does not disappoint, which is quoting from St. Paul to the Romans, right? We are to have this hope now, that even in a time of suffering, we should have this hope, because this hope is deeper than just a feeling. This hope is given to us in our baptism. We foster this hope when we pray, when we bring our intentions to the Lord. We do not let despair get to us, because we have hope in Christ, who is our foundation, who is our hope. This hope shows us that the cross isn't the end, that on Good Friday, when Christ was taken down, that it didn't even end there, that the stillness and sorrow of Good Friday and Holy Saturday give light and give life and make way for the joy of the Easter season. Good Friday is one day. Holy Saturday is one day. Easter is a season that gives us 50 days, where the Church, in her wisdom, through her divine liturgies, gives us the chance to worship God and thank him for this hope. And they remind us in her prayers of this hope. Because come Pentecost, the disciples were distraught. And this gives them the hope. But this is the foundational moment. This Christ's resurrection gives us this hope. So this is the hope that we are given every time we are sent forth from Mass. This is the hope that makes us the light of Christ to the world. This is the hope we are to bring people when we evangelize to them. This is the hope we witness to in our life. We can fall so short of this in our day-to-day life. Right, where do we place our hope? Is our hope in Christ? And during our times of suffering and trial and tribulation, is our hope in Christ? Or do we hope for something less than heaven? Because if so, then we have forgotten where our hope should be. Christ is risen today. This is what we celebrated at the Easter Vigil and carrying through for the next 50 days. But this is what our life should be like. Do we remember that we have this hope, this definite hope in Christ? This was prefigured for us when Christ raised Lazarus from the dead. When Christ raised the mother's son, her only son, from the dead as well. Do we have this hope? So remember that it is through Christ, in Christ, and with Christ that we are healed, and we should have this hope. Because on Good Friday, it was by his wounds that we were healed. And on Easter Sunday, when he rose from the dead, it is in his resurrection that we have hope for heaven. The hope to be with him forever. Amen. Alleluia. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Christ is risen from the dead.